Welcome to the fourth video on Module 3 Random Number Generators. So in this video, I am going to explain you the different types of tests which are used to check whether the samples or the results which are obtained by the techniques of generating the random numbers are suitable for using in the simulation problems or no. So first, we have to check what actually these tests means, how they will be performed and what are the results. So first I'm moving to the tests for random numbers, frequency test. So this test uses Kolmogorov-Smirnov or the chi-square test to compare the distribution of the set of numbers generated to a uniform distribution. So here we are going to check or test for the uniformity. So here we have two hypotheses related to this, H0 and H1. H0 is if the random number, sample of the random numbers are uniformly distributed between 0 and 1, then it is told that H0 is accepted, on Ri the samples are accepted and they are uniformly distributed. If not, it is not uniformly distributed. Similarly, autocorrelation test tests the correlation between the numbers and compares the sample correlation to the expected correlation 0. So here the expected correlation always will be 0 because no relation should be maintained in between the numbers. So here first we are going to obtain the correlation value for all the numbers which are being generated, and that correlation value will be compared with the 0, that is the expected correlation value, and this correlation value, it should be as small as possible, then only the acceptance of the hypothesis will be more. So here also we have two hypotheses, H0 and H1. H0 states that the set of random numbers are distributed independently. H1 states that they are not distributed independently. If both of these kind tests have been done, and then we go for the acceptance or the rejectance test. Acceptance or the rejectance test is based on the value of alpha. So if the value of alpha is compared with the resultant value, and if it is equal or if it is less, then only we are going to accept the hypothesis, or else it will be rejected. So once we are fine with the frequency tests and autocorrelation test, next we are going to explain about the Kolmogorov-Smirnov test. This test compares the continuous CDF f of x of the uniform distribution with the empirical CDF Sn of x of the samples of n observations. So in this test, we are going to collect the samples of n observations, and those will be compared with the continuous CDF, that is f of x. So this test, it is done with the following steps. So step one is rank the data from smallest to the largest, that is we are going to arrange the sample in ascending order. Then we are going to step two. Step two tells us to compute the d plus and d minus values, that is d plus we obtain with the maximum of I by n minus ri, and d minus we obtain by maximum of ri minus I minus 1 by n. So once we compute d plus and d minus, then we go for computing d value. D value is computed by taking the maximum of d plus and d minus. So whichever is maximum in this, that will be considered as the d value. So once we get the d value, we are going for the d alpha value. So here in step 4, we are going to check the d alpha value from table 8 for the specified significance level alpha. So they will give you some value for alpha, and depending on the value alpha, we are going to check for the number of samples. So if the number of samples is 5, then here we have d of 0.05 as 0.565. so d alpha value will be considered as 0.565, and that d alpha value will be compared with the d value. And if d value is less than or equals to d alpha, then we are accepting those numbers, random numbers, sample of the random numbers. If not, it will be rejected. So here this can be explained with an example. In this example, we are seeing that suppose n equals to 5 numbers, that is a sample numbers, they have given us 5 numbers, 0.44, 0.81, 0.14, 0.05, 0.93, and it is desired to perform a test for the uniformity using the Kolmogorov-Smirnov test with a level of significance alpha value also they have specified as 0.05. So first we are going to obtain the values. So here step one is we are going to arrange the values which are given in the ascending order. So 0.05, 0.14, 0.44, 0.81, 0.93. So next step is to find D plus and D minus values. So D plus and D minus value, once we obtain, then we go for step 3, that is maximum of D plus and D minus will be considered as a D value. So here we get D value as 0.26. So once we get D value as 0.26, then we are going to compare that D value with the D alpha value. So in this table, we have seen for 5 samples and alpha value as 0.05, we are going to obtain D alpha value as 0.565. So that value will be considered, and we are comparing D alpha with the D. So this D alpha value is greater than the D value. So we are not rejecting, we are accepting the random numbers, and these random numbers can be used in our simulations. So once we have done with this, then those random numbers can be used in the simulation problems. So this is about Kolmogorov-Smirnov test. Thank you.